Colonization will be a bit limited until after you become Super Germany, but you do get events in this mod for free stuff. Okay. Alright. Oh, but you were asking. No, I haven't seen that recent footage. At least, I don't know which one you're talking about. But I don't find it hard to imagine. Yeah, I see why colonization is basically impossible. The closest thing we could get is from Danzig to, like, here, and it's not close enough. So, yeah, that makes sense how colonization might be a problem for us. But, you know, we've done colonization every other time we've played this game recently. I'm fine with a change of pace. Schleswig-Holstein question. I always... larger repercussions is the free German states will see Prussia as the true leader of the Confederation. Our mastery of Germany awaits. Denmark loses their core on these two. Very good. Gain prestige, lose infamy. All countries that North Germany's primary culture will get looked to Prussia event. Released Sachs-Lauenburg as an independent state. Okay. Release Holstein as an independent state. Country changes to Schleswig. Oh, so it splits up a bit. And an alliance. And they love us. Alright. Yeah, alright. That's nice. I'm fine with that. Sure.
You need to take Germany's Africa as well as Kaiser Wilhelm's land, which is northeastern Papua New Guinea.
Papua New Guinea. Yeah, why not? I'll do it. If we can. And if we can't, we'll just take it from somebody else later. Sure. You'll have to remind me at some point. What's next on the agenda? Is Austria next? Is there some other... Let me see. Oh, no. Austria comes after North Germany, right? We unite North Germany first, then Africa. I mean, Austria. Africa becomes much later. Invented raider group doctrine, and then we can call for a convention over the Danish Straits. Okay, a toll. Oh no, getting rid of the toll. Okay, whatever, alright. North German Confederation, we need nationalism and imperialism and all the core provinces. We still don't have that because UK hasn't done their coronation yet, which apparently gets rid of the Hanover. Never mind, they've already gotten rid of it. Never mind. Okay, so now we need nationalism, which is way down here. Doesn't happen until 1850. That's 10 years. More hints.
You need to take all of Austria's North German states.
Gotcha. Didn't even think about the fact that they probably have North German states. Not here. No. Which ones are the North German states? Is it these? You sure they have North German states? I'm just seeing Bohemian and Czechoslovakian states. Oh, you mean Sphere, the little countries. Yeah. We'll work on that.
What I mean is all of the states that they have cored.
Got it. Oh, wait. Cored. You mean sphered. You must mean sphered. In which case, I gotcha. Is the best way to do that to use influence or to go to war with them? This is the next question that I ask the experts in chat. Is it more efficient? Oh, I don't like that these guys are taking... They won't take here. What the fuck is this song? Warhammer 40k music. Oh, okay.
Sphere, fuck me.
Okay, alright. Sphere Luxembourg. Yeah, should we go to war and take their spheres, or should we not, because they're still a tough enemy at this stage? You even fucked up trying to say that with the bit donation. Good job. So what are we working on at this moment? Luxembourg, we've already got them. Stop. Hanover. Working on them. Very important. We need them. Good. Also, we need after that... Oh, these aren't... Oh, some of these aren't owned by anybody. Oh. Hanover. This one. Oh, these were all the British ones, I think. Yeah. Okay, Hanover first.
War, you pussy-footed that calls yourself a Prussian.
We've got one vote for war, you pussy, and one vote for diplomatically wait to war with Austria. More prestige.
Do you have the main Saxon state?
What would the main Saxon state be? You'd have to. Do you? You mean Hanover? What do you mean by this? Is there a Saxony? Isn't Saxony over here? No, wait. Yeah, isn't Saxony like here? Yeah. It said Saxony was here somewhere. Saxony. Here.
North of Bohemia.
Got it. No, we don't. In fact, we need to spear that. Clemens Baron Brentano was a German poet and novelist born in Ehrenbreitstein near Klobens. Brentano, whose early writings were published under the pseudonym Maria, belonged to the... Why would he... Okay. Group of romantic writers. His works were marked by excess of fantastic imagery and abrupt, bizarre modes of expression. Promoted the Catholic faith, and against his will, his works were seen as devotional literature. Cool. Has Clay, sure? Yeah, so this is important. You're right, we need Saxony. Hungary will rebel. Oh! Of course, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So we wait for Hungary to rebel before we fuck with the Austrians too much. It seems like then we probably could have taken more shit from Denmark because we're already gonna be like almost out of infamy soon. But you know, okay, all right, it's fine. It's not a big deal. What is Devilman? Sounds like the fucking even polka. You know, doesn't that part sound like the da 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 da? That's what... Oh, we have too many intellectuals. I always do this. I always make the people way too smart. And they become too powerful. Their minds, they start to rebel against the government authorities because they realize they don't have to. I keep clicking the same ones. There. Hanover. Very good. Add to sphere. Done. We're shooting through these. Next, we would like Saxony. Yes. I like how we start this listening to German marching music. We're now on anime intros.
With Austria, don't peace out when you have enough score.
Okay.
Destroy their country so that they fall out of the great powers long enough for your treaty to expire so you can spear them.
Gotcha. Okay. So fucking, when we go to war with Austria, a plan is forming. Austria will lose Hungary. They will be in a weakened state. We declare war. We take our war goals, get far enough to where they would peace out. Don't do it. And total war, burn the country to the ground so that they cannot rebuild in time for us to sphere, you know, bring our influence over them. Gotcha. I like this plan. This is going. This is all looking good. And we're making tons of... Well, no, tons isn't what I would say. But we're making good money considering we've got everything at max. We could probably afford... We've got a nice little sizable little nest egg. We could afford some more infantry, probably. Some more of something. Let's take a look at what our composition is like right now. That guy's got too many horses. We're gonna throw some horses over.
Remember, your war would be a good chance for more than 40% of the Austrian Empire to rebel.
That also makes sense. Yeah, going to war with Austria could make the rebellion happen. Instead of waiting for the rebellion to go to war with Austria, we could go to war with Austria to cause the war. I guess that also makes sense, yeah. Let's compare army sizes then. 67, 63. Okay, see, that's the kind of thing that makes me think maybe we should just wait because they are actually stronger than us.
If you have to let Hungary separate to keep Austria down and just take them later if you want. though they are the weird-ass Magyar ethnic group.
Okay. No, we can always just, like, fucking kill them or something, right? We're gonna have that option, I think. I believe this mod has, like, just a gas them choice, so we could just gas them. If we really are upset about there being Magyars in Hungary. Hungarian, yeah. I wonder what it shows up on as on the cultural map. Well, that's Romanian here. Hungarian. Hungarian, yeah. Gotcha. Yeah, we could just kill them if it's really, like, an issue. Or we could just conscript them and use them in our wars and kill them that way. I mean, it's not like they're gonna... It's not like they're gonna be, like, protected citizenry or anything. Oh, that just happened. Okay, perfect. Getting the research right on time. Limburg is also a goal. You can see they just popped out. Limburg. Is that, where is, Limburg. Here. Oh. When you mean a goal, you mean like long term, not like we actually need them.
Hungary is probably a date sensitive event.
That's probably true. Do you know when the date is? Actually, if someone could look that up, I'd be very thankful, because that would be great if we... Because, I mean, if it's in, like, 20 years, I don't think it is. But if it is, then fuck it. I'll just go to war now, or you know, soon. Also, right, I was going to increase my relations with the UK, because they are allies with us. On one hand, they're a very good ally, because they're the number one country in the world. They've got a great navy. We complement each other. Overseas endeavors, they're going to be a lot stronger than us. So they cover our weakness, whereas we're a lot stronger than them on the continent. We end up covering their weakness. We don't really care about covering their weakness, of course, but we do. It worked out that way. But also, it would be nice to actually have someone on the continent.
Whenever the actual revolt happened, there is a high chance that it will happen.
1848. Okay. Romantic sentiment and evolving nationalistic spirit of our people has evoked a high interest in the medieval age, which is seen as the root of the German culture. A symbol of these far away and backward times. Backward? Fuck off. Are the cathedrals of Gothic architecture. So I like the medieval times, having never been. Cologne, once the biggest German city, is one of the finest places in the times of the Holy Roman Empire. It's one of the greatest cathedrals in human history, which is a large abandoned construction area. Do we want to rebuild it? Yes. At least I assume that's what that said. I just kind of skimmed it after that point, but I assume it was asking if I wanted to rebuild it, and it's like, yeah, of course. 48, I think we can wait for that. Hanover wants an alliance, that sounds great. Yeah, I think we could probably wait for 48, and if it gets much further than that, then we'll know that, like, oh, it's not gonna pop out, fuck them then. Also, we wanted to make North Germany before going to war with Austria anyway. We can't do that until, like, 1850, so it's not like we're in a big rush. Which also means, again, that we probably could have taken Iceland and it wouldn't have been a big deal because we have plenty of time to make our infamy go down. But I'm not complaining or anything, I'm just saying. Which means we do have a lot of time to fuck around with some interesting divergences in history. Overseas is kind of hard to do, but not impossible. Colonization is basically impossible, but we could conquer someone.
Remember, technological advancement didn't halt in the Middle Ages, but the Renaissance stunned Europe.
Well, yeah, I know it didn't halt in the Middle Ages. I've heard, yeah. It's a misconception that it did.
The cathedral in Aachen is Charlemagne's throne, his grave, and a solid gold container containing one of Mary's dresses.
I did not know that. That sounds really fucking cool. Makes me want to visit. I've never really wanted to visit Germany much, but that makes me kind of want to visit. That sounds pretty fucking neat. Weavers Uprising. They deserved it, or I lose prestige. Well, I'm not gonna get prestige, so I don't want to lose it. More German music, good. What is our composition looking like before we make some more troops? We've got good amount of infantry. Could use some artillery here, certainly. Here we've got fuck ton of infantry. We could use some more artillery. Here is pretty decent distribution, I guess. There are just some dragoons sitting around. You go there, I guess. Then we've got pretty decent, again, I'd say. And fairly decent. So I think we'll pump out like 4 artillery, maybe a little more. You know what? 5 is actually perfect. We'll do 5. And then we'll distribute those down there. Obviously, these groups are a little big for what, for anything. They're going to attrition a lot. We'll worry about that. Maybe never. Oh, the Yucatan split off. That won't last long. Same with Los Altos. Austria's trying to stop me from taking Saxony. It's not working. it's not working. And Hanover we already have, so stop that. Yeah, like, if we wanted to, we could take over, say, Vietnam or Burma, Aceh, Johor, the classic choices. This is apparently not owned by the Dutch right now. That's a satellite. Never mind. We could also take over the Dutch.
The Dark Ages encompass only the period directly after the Migration Period. It pisses me off when people call the entire Middle Ages the Dark Ages.
No, you're right. Yeah, it's a very common misconception that the Dark Ages was the Middle Ages. It's not true. Yeah. You don't have to tell me. I like the Middle Ages aesthetically enough that I looked into, you know, the fact that they weren't as shit as people say. Plus, you know, the average peasant worker in the past had less work hours than the average person today? Not me. I work like a peasant. And they had sweet traditional wives that they would have tons of kids with and live on their farms and, I'm sure it was great, you know, there was the plague and such, and there was no voting, and there was all that sort of thing, but, you know, there's pros and cons to everything in life, and I can't say we're on the better side of the deal here. Oh, okay, yeah, this actually worked out perfect. Yeah, we could go to war with, like, Netherlands. They're not that strong. They're allied with no one exactly super powerful. I mean, Portugal and Spain, I guess, is a something.
By tons, you mean half of them would die before 10.
Well, I mean, it's not untrue. Can't go to war with Belgium. I don't. UK is our ally. We don't want to fuck with that. We could actually go to the war with the Netherlands, maybe.
Though the Migration Period had some confusing ass stuff happen, it doesn't help that there aren't very many records from the period.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. What is... Whoa. Oh, UK. Oh, okay. So what do you think? Asian conquest? Or otherwise fucking just overseas conquest? Or try and pick on some minor neighbor? Maybe we take over Switzerland? Seems like the kind of thing you can't justify war. What do you mean? We don't have borders, or because like they're just because they're, are there some people we just can't justify war on? No, we can justify, if we can justify war on the Pope, we should be able to justify war on Switzerland, okay? It would make sense if maybe it had a thing like people get mad at you because they're famously neutral or whatever the fuck, but I should still be able to do it. Okay. Vassalize Sweden. It's not the worst idea, except that they are our ally.
Attack the Dutch? I don't know. If unsure, just invade Asian places.
Honestly, I think I'm going to invade Asian places. Because now that I'm looking at it, the Dutch themselves are pretty weak. And I was kind of underestimating Spain and Portugal. Spain and Portugal together are actually not something to fucking discount. So, yeah, we'll take one of these groups up. We will go to war with some little nobody. Maybe we'll even get a little African nation as a jumping off point for colonization later. I kind of like that idea. Now, I have to remember how this works in this mod, because it's different in every single fucking mod. For 15, we could establish a protectorate. That's expensive, but if it works, that's, you know, that's 300,000 people and a nice little base of operations. Here's a 500,000 for the same price. Much better deal.
It also makes me mad when people say that the Roman Empire fell simply due to their own incompetence. Try keeping a country together when every German warrior tribe is running from the Huns directly into you.
I don't think I've ever heard someone say that Rome fell apart because of their incompetence. We need more research. We need to get nationalism and imperialism as fast as we can, so we'll start our way there. Release Luxembourg and Limburg from the Dutch. Yeah, but I'm thinking we won't be able to beat the Dutch is the thing. Or at least it'd be very hard. Then again, we have the UK on our side. Oh, shit. No, see, this is the problem. The UK has 41 military power. Spain has also 41 military power. Like, Spain is actually... Why, though? Why do they have that much military power? That's stupid. What are you... From leaders? Okay, never mind. Let's look at the actual numbers here. UK has 79. This is, of course, assuming that they actually decide to help. But if they... At the very least, they'll have boats that might be able to block the Spanish from even getting up here, which would be great. This is one of the... okay, yeah. 27. We have, of course, like 60. 68. All of our allies as well.
Once again, the snow naggers east tore Europe like in World War I and II in the EU.
Naggers. I think we're actually going to do this. This actually seems like it won't be so bad. Now, it's possible that the UK won't join because there is one chain of events I could see happening. Netherlands goes to war. They call in Spain and Portugal. Portugal joins, UK doesn't join me because Portugal is in the war. But I guess I would call in UK before any of that would happen, so it wouldn't actually... No, I guess that'll probably work out. Let's try and go to war with Netherlands. They like me too much. Well, we can change that. Yeah, why not, right? I don't know what we're going to take from them. We can release those countries, like you said. We could just take them, probably. We could puppet them. Well... We could place in the sun is kind of interesting, but cheap, so I wouldn't want to do that. We could acquire a state. How many states is the Netherlands? Like two?
Forgot the Portuguese or Swimby.
Swooby. I don't know what you mean by that. Yeah, like we could just take part of it. We could puppet them. I'm not really sure what we want to do. I mean, this is like German enough to take. We could take this up here. There's some German people here, even. We have to save our North German brethren who are stuck in the Netherlands. Makes sense to me. Why not, right?
The Germanic Wimpy tribe.
It keeps saying wimpy, it sounds like. Release the two, puppet the Dutch. That makes sense. Yeah. I guess we'll puppet the Dutch, sure. Puppet. I usually don't do puppeting as much, but you know, change of pace. It's not like we could take all of them anyway, and if we only take part of them, it'll look kind of ugly. So, yeah. Let's relocate our troops to get to the Dutch border. Also, we want them just sort of closer over here.
Well, the Portuguese lost to the Germanic cred once they adopted the Latin shit.
Right. Yeah, I knew there was some vague relation between the... Well, no, maybe I didn't know that. I don't know. It's weird. Let me take a quick drink. Okay, so, yeah, if we're lucky, I mean, UK has a ridiculous amount of boats. Like, nothing can get through those boats. So, if they just sit them right here in the English Channel, the Spanish and the Portuguese aren't getting through that. And if they can't get access through the French or, like, up through the Austrians or something, they're not getting to me. And it'll be very easy to fully siege the Netherlands and have no problem. Are our troops in place? Most of them, yeah. Go here, I guess. It's not really that important. You stay there. No, you go here. Okay, now it's done. Now we declare war on the Netherlands. We see what would happen. They've got Spain, Portugal, etc. Will the UK join? They will. Everyone will join. Every single one. Sweden, even? Yeah. Oh, nice yodeling. This sounds like, is this Franzl Lang, the famous yodeler?
Remember, German Empire had the second most powerful navy at the start of World War I because they were Anglo-Boos.
I did not know that. I was just making fun of their navy. I mean, I knew they had a decent navy, but I didn't think they had an amazing one. I didn't know that. The UK didn't join. They said they would join, and then they didn't join. Sweden joined? Yeah, Sweden joined. Portugal joined on the other side. They're still allied with the UK, but the UK didn't join on the other side, which is very good. We'll try and make an alliance with them in a second. They'll probably accept it again. Let's move in. Let's lower the speed a bit, so it just doesn't blaze by. Go there. You move up. This is all looking fine. Because we don't have the UK helping us out, we're not going to have just a barricade here, which sucks, but...
Everyone is talking about the Black Panther movie without realizing that the character is named after a black supremacist group.
I don't think anyone doesn't know that Black Panther is named after the Black Panthers. I think everybody knows that. I don't think you're breaking new ground with that one. Two Sicilies wants alliance. Okay, well, are you interested? No, that's Sardinia Piedmont. Two Sicilies. You want some of this war? They will not accept. Well, what the fuck are you even doing this for? Sardinia Piedmont, I still really like an alliance again. Other Sphere Leader. Oh, okay, so that's not happening. Other Sphere Leader, they're a great power. Oh, they're not, but they will be. I see.
The Eternal Anglo had a law at either time saying that they must spend their naval budget larger than the second and third most powerful navies.
Huh. I didn't know that. That makes sense. That's kind of interesting. I'm thinking if we're able to siege the Netherlands completely here, we won't have a problem at all.
I've asked people at my school and most had never heard of the Black Panthers.
Oh, that is... Really? Where do you go to school? I assume you're U.S. If you weren't... If you're not U.S., then that makes perfect sense. That's U.S. history, you know? But if you're in the U.S., I mean, I learned about it in school. I'm not going to say our schooling system's amazing, but we did learn about that. Weird. Chartist rallies?
Black Panther comma came out right before the Maoist group started.
I didn't know that. That's interesting.
I'm in East Texas, remember?
East Texas? Well, I mean, okay. That's the Deep South. Well, wait, no, you'd think they would talk about it in the Deep South. Well, whether or not East Texas is considered part of the Deep South, I guess, is not necessarily... It might not necessarily be considered that, but it is the South. East Texas is like the most southern part of Texas, as far as I know. At least that's what people say. Never been. Not to East Texas. Chartist rallies. Again. Great. How are you feeling? It seems like maybe... No, okay. Netherlands, how are you feeling? We need to get quite a bit for you to capitulate here, but that shouldn't be hard to do. As far as additional war goals, what do you have as far as places in the sun? I'm just curious. Part of me still wishes we took Iceland. I really like the idea of that. I mean, technically, it is kind of ours right now because it's in our dominion. But that's not as cool as it being a different color. We need, like, a secret base so that Hitler can flee there after, you know. Because Antarctica isn't on the map, so he can't flee there. And, well, I guess he could always just go to Argentina. We need a backup plan.
It is in the Deep South, technically, but it's pretty different from the rest.
All right, that makes sense. Okay, this is all fine. We've got nothing being occupied. We're about to conquer all of it. Good. Censor the press? Sure, why not? Who are you fighting? Hamburg? Oh. Oh. Thanks, guys, I guess. I don't really need you little guys to be fighting naval battles for me. You're probably fine without that. What happens if I don't do this? They become more liberal, or they don't. Okay. I'd prefer to stay not liberal as long as I can. Now, I'm afraid that these Germans might have a different plan in mind, and that might not be something that lasts for very long. Netherlands is completely sieged, but they're only 20%. Now, doesn't that just seem kind of ridiculous? I mean, they're 100% sieged. Everything. I understand they've got allies that could save them, and that's what they're banking on. But still, oh, I guess it's not 100% because they're fucking overseas shit. Yeah. I guess that kind of fucking, I guess that makes sense. Are we ticking up? We should be, right? I don't know, actually. We might not be. So Spain and Portugal. Can we actually get access through France? Now, France probably hates us. Oh. Okay. We actually can get access through France. Thank you, France. You know, I don't like you, but that was a very nice thing of you to do. They might be trying to ship troops over. But we will send some troops down here. What do they have? They are mobilized. So is Portugal. They've got 43 brigades. Which is like, what, 120,000? That's right here. That's like 120,000. So we've got enough to send down. That'll be fine. Especially since a lot of them are going to be pretty shit. So let's start your way down. Can we move across Belgium? No, we can't. That becomes very important later. Historically, it becomes very important whether or not Germany can move across Belgium. We will, in fact, take four groups with us, and we will leave this last one for little excursions they might try and make, little stupid things they might try and make, little landings and such. I mean, obviously, we've got a bunch of little guys who can help with that. A bunch of boats that are going to be sunk while they try and get over here, but we want to be safe. Come down here. I don't want to go just directly right to the front, just on the off chance that they're going to have a big force right there. It's also why I want to send them kind of together as much as I can. That's not really going to happen. Liberal Students Association. Whatever. I wonder when Yeoman realizes the video I added is for 40 minutes. Right now. Skip. Next. This is good, though. Tank. Although I like a lot of the other songs that show up in the show better. But it's a good intro. It just gets played a lot. Well, I mean, as far as any of this kind of shit. It's not like it gets played on the radio. Saxony removed from sphere. Fuck off, Austria. You can command the Danish forces. No fucking way. No, I can't. Command you... Oh! What? I told you, I have never... Oh, shit. I have never actually done puppets. I didn't realize that was how that worked. That's fucking great. I love that. Okay. Well, we're still just going to leave them around there just in case anyone tries to land. Is that the Baltic? They're not hostile to us. I had no idea you could do that. That's pretty fucking cool. All right, let's get on the... Oh, that's Andra. I can't actually go there? Yeah, I can't. Okay. Well, that makes me kind of like puppeting people a little bit more. Okay, so they do have some big groups here. That's France. Is France at war with... No, they're just walking through Spanish lands. Just vacation. We will surround this grouping. Because that's the only one I can see right now. Interesting. Do you actually think that's a good idea? Okay, I am very happy to dogpile into this Spanish province and just kill them when our reinforcements cut. We actually won before. They gave up. Oh, nice. Go there. You stay there. No. You go here. And we start our siege. Very good. Yeah. This is actually perfect. We shouldn't even fuck with the Spanish. If they attack us, obviously we're gonna fuck with them. But okay, Spanish. I mean, this didn't work well for you last time, but we'll do this again. You want another go at it? We'll do it again. Die wacht am Rhein. Nice. More jingoism. And prestige and all that. State and government, very good. Very soon we'll be able to get nationalism, and then we'll be able to get the North German Federation. Confederation. We need to make people smarter here. Probably the people in the other places are too smart. Oh yeah, wow. Okay. I mean, if it's below 4, it's not like you're still getting something out of it, apparently. And then Prussian Rhineland. Okay. But yeah, it is a bit wasteful. It's more than we want. They're going to where? Two different places. Oh, okay. We're going to win there, and then we reinforce here. This is a little more combat than I'd actually like. A little more losses being taken than I'd actually like. I think I'm just going to stay in these two big groups for a little bit, at least till these sieges are done. Okay, the siege is done. I'm going to keep one of the groups behind, and then one of them here. Oh. No, that's actually fine. I still want to go there, so I'll just kill them. This one will stay together. So this one will reinforce until they attack it. That's fine. Because now this is done, so now we can just kill them without worrying about it at all. Continue this siege. Very good. Yeah, we might fuck with Spain.
It was a confederation, but became a federation, so that's what it's called in game.
Oh, okay. Oh, this is interesting. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. So this is Duvet, or Duvet, by Boa, which is the Lane song, and, oops. I was about to say an autistic version of this song. There's an acoustic version of this song in the album that this song is in, but this is an acoustic cover of it. Well, I kind of like it. It's a different take on it.
You like the cover?
I do, yeah, I actually kind of like this. It's a little softer than the actual acoustic version, which I'm fine with. I'll send them there, okay. Yeah, it's interesting. I like it. I mean, it's a good song. It's hard to fuck up. Tell me if it's really quiet. It's all of these, it's hard to tell. I just don't want to blast anybody. Because usually when I go to edit these afterwards, I'm amazed at how loud it is and that no one said anything. Okay, now we have more stuff we need to take from the Austrians. We have all of this. Who? What? How did Austria get... Austria sphered Holstein. How did you even do that? How are we not informed? Oh yeah, Austria's trying for all these. We're gonna have to go to war with Austria before too long. That makes sense, I guess. In fact, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to... No, I'm not gonna do anything. This is going well, though. You're going to attack here. Another just interesting choice, I mean... Oh, with the Portuguese! Okay, that's new. They'll probably stop now. Yeah. Yeah. And we siege another province. And we wait for them to go and attack those guys. What the fuck do you... Oh, no, wait. There's another province there. Come down and attack them. This is probably making the Netherlands feel a little bit worse about their war. It is. What we can probably do here... We can probably add a war goal and peace out separately with Spain. Now, this is where we sort of want to determine how fucking ridiculous do we want this to make? How much border gore do we want? Because technically, we could take, like, I don't know, the Balearic Islands. Although that's part of Catalonia, so we would take all of that. Now, currently, that might look like really bad borders, but if we conquered all of France, then it would look very nice. or worse. We could do that. We could take over some colony they have somewhere in the middle of, you know, fucking nowhere. Which might actually be a great idea. Cuba? We could take Cuba. We could take Cuba. German Cuba, I really like the sound of. It's stupid, obviously. We've also got some places I don't even fucking know. We could just make them a puppet. We could try, anyway. That's the going thing to do. That's the hip thing to do so far. Zero border gore. Take nothing or colony. You see, that's why I like colonies, because, yeah, it really isn't border gore. It's just extra little bonus things.
At least take all of the Third Reich at its height.
Well, sure. If you do any border gore, I will unfollow and report you to Twitch. The part of that that's concerning is not that you'd report me for border gore, but you'd report me for anything else I do on stream that I somehow haven't been caught yet. Because just like Germany, I've been racking up the bad boy points on Twitch. And we'll see when they finally decide, like, okay, that's too far. You know what I was thinking of, actually? Do you think Twitch would get really mad at me if I instituted a thing, like, I was just thinking, I thought it'd be funny. Whenever I get, like, a sub or something, there's just a voice in the background laughing maniacally and saying, like, you've fallen for my Jewish tricks. Because I've gotten your money. And you get the hand-rubbing sound in the background. Do you think Twitch would not enjoy that one? I have a feeling that's the kind of thing that Twitch would be like, ooh. Anti-Jacobin tract. Yeah, sure. You know, I have a feeling they'd be like, no. No, we're not gonna allow the Jewish tricks. I don't know why they attacked. Even without reinforcing, they were gonna lose that. These people are just dumb sometimes. Directly mentioning Jews might be touchy, but Bro Team has one that says, ha ha ha, you spent money on this, you fucking loser. Yeah, well, I'm sure we can do that. I just like the term Jewish tricks. maybe that's not something I should say, but I think it's just funny.
Yes, everything that you say, think, or do Twitch will come down on you like Big Brother.
I'm not surprised. I mean, you can't worry about it. I've realized that just you can't worry about what you say on Twitch because they are so inconsistent with how they apply their rules that you can break rules and then never get in trouble for them, or you can never break rules and still get in trouble. So why even fucking worry about it?
You could go with calling the sub a Zoigoi or keep everything but keep out the dialogue.
That's true. Just maniacal, vaguely Jewish-sounding laughter. Just in the background. Are you that Byzantine emperor by chance? No. Not that I know of. Okay, this is going so much better than, like, any war we have ever done against someone this big. This is a great power. No, they're not. They might not be a great power because of me, though. I might have done that to them. No one went and sieged over here, did they? Oh. I've got a sixth sense for it. I felt that there were Spanish in my lands. Why can't you move in your own land? Because there are Netherlands there. Oh. Oh, okay. Can we make it? No. What kind of boats are those? Oh, shit. Okay, well, we can always do these. These will work just fine. What? Huh? What, because I can't move No, of course. We can't move through Holstein. Would you let us? Would you let... Maybe. What is this? Is this French rap? This goes against my German aesthetic for a lot of reasons. Let's fuck up these Spanish, then let's move forward here and here. Luxembourg just left.
Not enough.
You know, it's kind of weird when you're saying something with the bid donation thing that has that was only it's a conversation that's just happening in chat, but you're responding with bid donations. Oh, you're talking about the Bulgar slaying. Oh, I see. Yeah. Yeah, that's not me. Crease opinion with Holstein. Yeah, so these troops are worthless. And Sweden can't help. Okay, that's looking good. This is looking good. Move up to Cuenca. Netherlands is looking pretty bad, generally. Let me just make sure. They are negotiating merely for themselves. That's perfect. We probably want to add a war goal. We'll still think about what we want, though. Cuba is tempting. It is extremely tempting. Puppeting them is also extremely tempting. Puppeting them is almost more tempting. Because that'd be a very good ally against the French. And I really like that, just, again, aesthetically, that we are forcing ourselves to have allies. We're not being, like, good neighbors. We're not being good diplomats. We're not convincing people of how nice it would be if they were our ally. We're conquering them and, like, installing people that would ally us. And, you know, there's something really German about that. He's doing it out of habit now. You can turn up the donations and he'll still throw pennies at you. Ooh. Will you play Kingdom Come on stream? You know, I've actually been kind of looking for a new game to start, and you know, that's actually a pretty good idea. Why not? Yeah, I probably will. I kind of forgot about it, actually. I kind of forgot that came out. But yeah, it's not a bad idea. Saxony Alliance, cool. Yeah. I'll have to pick it up. And I'll also have to make the judgment call of whether or not I buy it or... Oh, that's why I hadn't played it yet. I was waiting for it to get some patches first.
Fucking do rubbing your hands together.
Oh, that rubbing almost hurt. That was so intense rubbing. Don't say anything bad about the Jews. Twitch loves Jews. You're getting a lot of trouble. This is just music theory is simple. You just put up a video about how to do music theory. We're not going to listen to that. Kingdom Come is glitched to all hell. Now, see, when you phrase it like that, that just makes me want to play it. Most of the time, people say, like, it's fucking super buggy and it's not worth playing. But when you say it's glitched to all hell, it just makes me think of, like... like a Bethesda game where you might get some fun glitches, maybe.
You should do ASMR with those hands.
You like that? Probably could. I'd have to buy one of those weird ear microphones where it's like a microphone turned sideways with two human ear replicas on each side. But we could. That and just soft whispers.